Here I have a new 2025 Toyota Camry. It's the first model year of the 9th generation. I drove the previous gen 2024 Camry a few months ago, and I think each has its own benefits and shortcomings. I'm going to go over 5 pros and cons of the new Camry and compare it to the previous gen to see how they stack up against each other. So first, let's head inside and go over the interior. I love the new interior. It's refreshed for the new generation, looks modern, and upscale. The 2024's interior looks dated with its physical gauges, especially when compared to rivals like the Honda Accord or Hyundai Sonata. You have plenty of charging options here, a nice easy-to-use center screen, and digital gauge cluster. It's a little small, but it shows a decent amount of information, and you can get a larger screen in the XSE and XLE trims. Next, we have to talk about the driver assist tech in this car. Toyota's always loading their vehicles with safety features. In the Camry, you have automatic braking, rear traffic alert, adaptive cruise control, blind spot monitoring, and even lane tracing assist, which is basically its self-driving feature. The car will follow the lanes on the road, and it's great for long highway drives. Both the 2024 and 2025 have great tech. You can't go wrong with either. I think the lane tracing assist is improved on the 2025 model. The 2024 model seems a little less precise, and it also has a weird issue where the car will try pulling you into the exit lane on the highway. I haven't noticed that on the 2025. I also noticed that the car will automatically brake harder if it sees that you're getting too close or coming up quickly on a car ahead of you. I don't remember the 2024 doing this. Next is the fact that Toyota and reliability are pretty much synonymous. The Toyota Camry is a very reliable car. These cars are known to last 200, 300,000 miles and more. Regular maintenance should keep this car going for a long time. There's a reason that it's America's most popular midsize sedan, and it has been for the last 20 plus years. You can't go wrong with the 2024 or 2025 here. I would say the 2024 is probably a slightly better option for long-term reliability, just because it's the final iteration of the 8th gen, so most issues have already been resolved by now. The 2025 is a new model, so there might be some quirks, issues that don't get ironed out until the 2nd or 3rd year. But in general, Camrys don't really have any major issues. Next is fuel efficiency. Modern Toyota Camrys have become very fuel efficient, especially the hybrid models. For now, all 2025 Camrys are hybrids, so the fuel mileage is good across the board. The base LE with front wheel drive gets 53 city, 50 highway, 51 combined, while the XSE with all wheel drive gets 44 city, 43 highway, 44 combined. The 2024 has a number of engine options, so the best fuel mileage is in the LE hybrid with front wheel drive, which gets 51 city, 53 highway, 52 combined, and the worst fuel mileage is in the TRD model with front wheel drive and the V6. This gets 22 city, 31 highway, 25 combined. A small sacrifice for more fun. So if you're looking for a hybrid model specifically, then either year is good. If you want to stay away from the hybrids, then the 2024 model is the one for you. Lastly, the 2025 Camry is quiet and roomy. One thing I noticed immediately after driving a few miles in the 2025 is how much quieter it is than the 2024. That one had a surprising amount of wind noise. This car is a lot better to deal with at highway speeds, no complaints here. And being the midsize sedan that it is, you have plenty of space for passengers and cargo. Available space is the same on both years, so you can't go wrong with either. So there are 5 pros to the 2025 Toyota Camry. Already I see some improvements from the previous gen. There are some things that are not so great. Most of my cons have to do with the lack of engine options and trims, so don't get upset if it sounds like I'm bringing up the same point, but let's start there. So first, let's talk about the exterior styling. The new Camry has a more modern design, but it's not as bold or exciting as the previous gen. With the 2024, I love the fact that you can get a basic, understated look, get a more sporty looking variant, and go completely wild with the TRD version. That one comes with a big wing, body kit, more aggressive looking wheels, and actually has performance upgrades to back up the look. Not many cars have that many options or straddle the extremes of under the radar family sedan and boy racer sedan. So that's something I wish the 2025 still had. All the trims look pretty similar. Since all the 2025 models are hybrids, there is no more V6. This is a little disappointing because the V6 actually makes the car a lot of fun to drive. The most powerful version of the 2025 model only has 232 horsepower. This is an improvement from the previous gen's hybrid models, but it's nowhere near the 301 horsepower from the V6. The 2024 TRD can sprint to 60, in 5.6 seconds, while the fastest 2025 model can only do 6.8. Like I said before, this is an improvement from the previous gen hybrids, but not as good as the V6. So if you're looking for a sporty family sedan with the grunt to back it up, the 2024 is the one to go with. Next is the handling. The 2024 SE handled pretty well, and the 2025 is decent too, but it doesn't even come close to the 2024 TRD model. I understand that most people won't care about this since it is a family sedan, but it is nice being able to have a car that can do it all. Pick up the groceries, transport the family, and be taken to the track or some canyon roads for some spirited driving. Aside from the Hyundai with its N-line, there aren't many family sedans that can do what the TRD model does. So if this is important to you, the 2024 Camry is the one to go with. And then I promise, this is the last con having to do with the lack of engine options or trims. The fact that all 2025 models are hybrids means that you can't go with a simpler engine option that is most likely to last longer and with less issues. The hybrid models are reliable and they can last long, but repairs and maintenance can get pricey when the hybrid battery or other components need to be replaced. So it kind of sucks that you can't opt for an easier to manage engine that you can work on yourself or repair easily once the car does get to the higher mileages. So if you prioritize simplicity with your drivetrain, go with the 4-cylinder or V6 in the 2024. And then lastly, these are some minor issues, but the fact that keyless entry is not standard across all trims and just how needy the lane tracing feature is. As I stated before, the lane tracing feature has been improved for 2025, but it is extremely needy to the point that it gets annoying. You have to jiggle the steering wheel every 15 seconds, otherwise the car will start beeping at you. You can probably turn the beeping off, but you constantly still need to jiggle the wheel. Otherwise, it'll just deactivate and show alarms all over the screen. I drove the new Hyundai Sonata recently, and the auto driving features in that car are fantastic. You can go over a minute without the car asking you to touch the wheel, and you can just rest your hand on it. You don't need to jiggle it. Regarding the keyless entry, I didn't realize how annoying not having it was. Most of the new cars I drive nowadays come with its standard. The Honda Accord, which is the closest competitor, has a standard on all trims. So it's annoying when you're in a rush and need to fumble around for your keys to unlock the door. You can get it as an option or on higher trims, but I think they all should just come with it. So there you have my 5 pros and cons to the new 2025 Toyota Camry. What are your thoughts? Do you like the new 2025 model, or do you prefer one of the 2024 models? I understand why Toyota has simplified the Camry lineup, but it was nice that the 8th gen had a trim for just about everyone. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. See you in the next one.